Welcome to an example on how to factor a trinomial in the form ax squared plus bx plus c using the grouping technique when a is not a common factor. Looking at the given trinomial, we have negative 4x squared plus 8x plus 21. Remember, the first step in any factoring problem is to factor out the greatest common factor. But in this case, there's nothing to factor out because the greatest common factor is 1. However, notice the leading coefficient is negative. When factoring, we almost always prefer to have the leading coefficient to be positive. And because of this, we'll begin by factoring out negative 1 from all three terms. If we factor out negative 1 from the given trinomial, we'd have negative 1 times, let's put the resulting factor in brackets. If we factor out negative 1 from negative 4x squared, we're left with positive 4x squared. If we factor negative 1 out of positive 8x, we're left with negative 8x, which we'll write as minus 8x. If we factor negative 1 out of positive 21, we're left with negative 21, which we'll write as minus 21. Notice how if we distribute negative 1, we still have negative 4x squared plus 8x plus 21. And now we'll use the factor by grouping technique to factor the trinomial inside the brackets. To do this, we first find two integers, which we'll call R and S, that have a product equal to A times C, where A is the coefficient of x squared, and C is the constant term, and whose sum is equal to B, where B is the coefficient of the x term. So we're looking for two integers, R and S, that have a product of A times C and have a sum of B. Once we find R and S, we'll write the given trinomial in the form AX squared plus rx plus sx plus c, and factor by grouping. So we use the values of r and s to write the x term, or degree 1 term, as the sum or difference. So looking at the trinomial inside the brackets, notice a is equal to 4, b is equal to negative 8, and c is equal to negative 21. So to find the values of r and s, we're looking for two integers that have a product equal to a times c. A times c is 4 times negative 21, which is negative 84, and that have a sum of b, which is negative 8. Notice how because the product is negative, one integer will be positive and one integer will be negative. To help us find the value of r and the value of s, let's list the pairs of integers that have a product of negative 84. Let's begin with negative 1 times 84, as well as negative 84 times 1. And we could have negative 2 times 42, as well as negative 42 times 2. And because there are so many pairs of integers that have a product of negative 84, it can be helpful to use the prime factorization of 84 to help us determine some of these products. Notice how, looking at the prime factorization, if we use a factor of 3, 84 is equal to 3 times 2 times 2 times 7, which is 28, which means for negative 84, we could use negative 3 times 28, as well as negative 28 times 3. And because 2 times 2 is 4, we know 84 is equal to 4 times 3 times 7, which is 21, which means we could use negative 4 times 21, as well as negative 21 times 4. Looking back at the prime factorization of 84, notice how 2 times 3 is 6, and 2 times 7 is 14, and therefore 6 times 14 equals 84. So for negative 84, we can use negative 6 times 14, as well as negative 14 times 6. And finally, because 2 times 2 times 3 is 12, 12 times 7 equals 84. So for negative 84, we could use negative 12 times 7, as well as negative 7 times 12. Now remember, we're looking for the two integers that have a product of negative 84, but also have a sum of negative 8, which means we're looking for the integers negative 14 and positive 6, again, because negative 14 times 6 equals negative 84, and negative 14 plus 6 equals negative 8. So let's let r equal negative 14 and s equal positive 6. Which means we'll write minus 8x as minus 14x plus 6x. And then we'll factor by grouping. So we have negative 1 times, in brackets, we have 4x squared. Again, we're going to write minus 8x as minus 14x plus 6x, and we still have minus 21. And now we'll factor the four terms inside the brackets using the technique of factor by grouping. So we'll divide these four terms into two groups, factor out the greatest common factor from 4x squared minus 14x and from 6x minus 21, and we should have a common binomial factor. Factoring 4x squared minus 14x, the greatest common factor is 2x, so we'll factor out 2x. If we factor out 2x from 4x squared, we're left with 2x. If we factor out 2x from negative 14x, we're left with negative 7, or minus 7. And now looking at just 6x minus 21, notice how the greatest common factor is 3. So we'll factor out positive 3, so we'll write plus 3. If we factor out 3 from 6x, we're left with 2x. If we factor out 3 from negative 21, we're left with negative 7, or minus 7. And notice how, looking at the products inside the brackets, the products do have a common factor of 2x minus 7, so we'll factor out 2x minus 7 from these two products. So negative 1 times, factoring out 2x minus 7, we'd have the quantity 2x minus 7 times the remaining factor of 2x plus 3. So this is now factored properly, but we normally see it in a different form. We can now drop the brackets, and instead of writing negative 1, we can just put a negative sign in front of the two binomial factors. So this form is equivalent to negative, then the quantity 2x minus 7 times the quantity 2x plus 3. Again, these two forms are equivalent, but this is the more common form for the factored form of the given trinomial. I hope you found this helpful.